American actress Meghan Markle and Prince Harry finally tied the knot this morning after months of anticipation. Close to an estimated billion people are believed to have tuned into the festivities, and social media is buzzing with details about the big day. Meghan arrived at St. George's Chapel with her mother in a vintage Rolls Royce and was escorted down the aisle by Prince Charles because her father is having health issues and was not able to make the trip overseas. The whole ceremony went smoothly and there were not any visible blunders. Prince Harry and Meghan smiled the entire time and looked very much in love. Meghan was joined in the beginning and end by page boys and bridesmaids, including the children of her friend Jessica Mulroney, and of course, her niece and nephew, Prince George and Princess Charlotte, who looked absolutely adorable. Music at the ceremony was beautiful but very unique to the royal family. The Kingdom Choir, a world-renowned gospel group, performed Stand By Me and This Little Light of Mine. An orchestra led by conductor Christopher Warren Green played a majority of the tunes, and Welsh soprano singer Eileen Manahan Thomas accompanied the choir. Following the ceremony, Harry and Meghan greeted fans at the front of the church and shared a kiss in front of fans before being escorted off to their reception in a carriage. Now, we just have to talk about Meghan's wedding look. The overall ensemble got mixed reviews from fans who were surprised by the simplicity compared with elaborate royal dresses in the past. Meghan's dress was designed by Claire Keller at Givenchy and featured 3/4-length sleeves, a sculpted waist, and no embellishment. It was a bit loose on her, but classic nevertheless. She opted to keep her hair and makeup very simple. Perhaps the best part of the look was Meghan's tiara, which came from Queen Mary and dates back to 1931. Her veil floated behind her seamlessly as she walked down the aisle to her fiancé. Famous wedding guests included Serena Williams and her husband Alexis, who was the co-founder of Reddit, George and Amal Clooney, who looked absolutely stunning as always, many castmates from Suits, Elton John, David and Victoria Beckham, Oprah Winfrey, Priyanka Chopra, James Corden and his wife Julia Carey, among many other A-listers. Kate Middleton's family was in attendance, including pregnant Pippa Middleton and her husband, who looked stylish as always. Viewers were shocked during the ceremony when the camera panned in to reveal that Harry's ex-girlfriend, Chelsea Davey, was in attendance. The cameraman totally threw shade and we kind of loved it. Harry wasn't shy about inviting his exes because Cressida Bonas was also invited despite having dated a few years ago. Queen Elizabeth stood out from the crowd in a bright green hat and jacket, and she was joined by her husband, Prince Philip, who made his first appearance since getting surgery. William and Kate looked lovely, and it has been revealed that Kate actually wore a repeat outfit with an off-white Alexander McQueen coat dress that has been proven to be a staple in her wardrobe. It's hard to believe that she just had a baby considering how good she looks in her pre-baby attire. Now, we just have to talk about Charlotte's adorable wave at the end to the crowds. She clearly has the right bubbly personality to be a princess. Now that the ceremony is over and the couple are officially married, they have a honeymoon in Africa to look forward to before settling down in Nottingham Cottage at Kensington Palace. But I'm curious to hear your thoughts on the wedding. Let us know what you think of the guests, ceremony, and outfits in the comment section below. Be sure to join the Taco family by hitting the subscribe button and make sure you turn on notifications to be alerted every time a new video goes live. Thanks for watching and we'll see you next time.